As cities become more populated and traffic congestion increases, people are looking for alternative ways to get around quickly and efficiently. We know that PEVs offer a cost-effective and eco-friendly way to navigate our busy streets. But how do they compare to the traditional method of transportation, the car, in terms of speed and convenience? And the answer there, at least in my tests, is neither. In my experience, it's pretty much a draw. And a city is a complicated place where the traffic conditions are in constant flux, and every person will have a different experience on any given day. However, there are some clear differences in the way that cars and PEVs each interact with the ebb and flow of city streets. So in an attempt to highlight those differences, I went ahead and performed some tests in the real world. I decided on a route that would start at the edge of Vancouver's downtown peninsula at the corner of Expo Boulevard and Smythe Street, and then headed down to Memorial South Park. That's about 8.1 kilometers on the scooter and either 7.8 or 8.3 kilometers in the car, depending on direction. I took the round trip three times on my Apollo City Pro, three in my car, with three separate departure times: early afternoon, afternoon rush hour, and late night. And I like real world tests, so this is not a race. And what that means is I'm going to ride and drive safely, but also to conditions. For example, when I ride my scooter to work, as long as I'm not on a shared path, I generally cruise at or below 35 kilometers per hour. But if the conditions are right, like a wide empty downhill road, I'm gonna get some speed. And in the car, going with the flow of traffic. And you know what that means. And a disclaimer here, these are imperfect tests done by this guy on different days. This is not scientific. But anyway, starting with the midday ride on the scooter, it was pretty quiet en route. However, there were a couple minor delays.
See, this is the thing. The biggest traffic problem you'll encounter, you're on an e-bike, an EC, e-scooter, whatever, are cars.
All in all, it took 20 minutes and 56 seconds to get to the park. And on the way back, no hiccups, which took 19 minutes and 5 seconds. The drive was all right, not too much traffic. It took 17 minutes and 29 seconds on the way there, and on the way back, took 19 minutes and 24 seconds. So right off the bat, we have a point for each. The rush hour ride was good, and I can't complain about the sunset on False Creek. There were a few delays from other riders and drivers. But it took 21 minutes to get there, and 19 minutes and 7 seconds to get back. In the car, I don't like driving in general, but during rush hour, that's a no for me, bud. That being said, the traffic wasn't that bad, though at one point I was momentarily blinded.
Holy
smokes!
Look at this, look at my face. That, ladies and gentlemen, is the Dodge Ram. Beautiful car, beautiful car.
And in the end, it took 22 minutes and 15 seconds to get there and 22 minutes and 22 seconds to get back, which gives 2 points to the scooter. For the late night ride, traffic was light. It allowed me to cross major streets without having to wait for the light to change, which resulted in the savings of about a minute and a half on the way there for a time of 19 minutes and 23 seconds, but seemingly no real gain on the way back at 18 minutes and 55 seconds. And the car trip had light traffic, which led to times of 15 minutes and 48 seconds and 16 minutes and 17 seconds, which gives 2 points to the car, giving us a soccer-style draw of 3-3. So there you have it. Depending on what time you need to get somewhere, either method will be the fastest way to get where you're going. Of course, there are a myriad of factors that will contribute to wildly different experiences in different places. I mean, even the route I took.
There was a reason why I didn't make the path downtown. This is that reason. It just wouldn't be fair.
And there's more than just the time it takes. For example, my car gets crap mileage in the city and consumed over $10 worth of gas for the 3 round trips, while the scooter used about 15 cents. Also, subjectively speaking, driving sucks. It's a stress inducer, while the scooter is a stress reliever. It's something I personally look forward to every day. Also, I deliberately left out parking, something that costs money, time, and peace of mind, though both modes have their own challenges when it comes to parking. But for me, a car is a bigger pain to deal with. And to be fair to the car, it's a comfy ride with easy access to hot tea. But something I'd like to highlight, something that I actually experienced and was demonstrated in the test results, is the capacity of micromobility to be unaffected by traffic. In the return trip on the scooter, there is a range of only 12 seconds between the 3 tests and a minute 40 in the other 3, which is a far cry from what we got in the car. And the differences in my test weren't that drastic, but we all know the effects of traffic while driving a car. you're much more susceptible to unexpected delays. And to drive this point home, I must confess something. I lied, and I am sorry. It wasn't a tie between the scooter and the car. I cut out some footage. This footage here, it's from the last car run, the late night lap. A lane was narrowed due to construction, slowing down my trip. And in the end, it took 22 minutes and 50 seconds, the longest of all the trips, giving up a point to the scooter. And with that point, the victory. But of course, like I said earlier, this is just a test that's little more than an anecdote. But I would like to hone in on the average speed for a moment. Here in my tests, the car clocked an average speed between 21.1 and 29.7 kilometers per hour, depending on the time of day. While the scooter had an average speed between 23.1 and 25.7 kilometers per hour, which again highlights the consistent speed compared to the car. As far as the city goes, the average speed in Vancouver is pretty much middle of the road. In comparison, New York has seen travel speeds through Manhattan decline consistently for the past decade, with an average speed of 11.4 kilometers per hour in the Central Business District and as low as 8 kilometers per hour in the Midtown Core. And while using a form of micromobility in New York won't be as quick as it is here in Vancouver, it certainly would be faster than taking trips in a car. Conversely, Phoenix, Arizona is seen as one of the fastest places to get around in the US with the average speed of 41.4 kilometers per hour, but considering it's the poster child of urban sprawl, that speed is the only thing helping you traverse the vast distances you need to cover to actually get anywhere. But either way, in the city where only 1.7% of commuters take public transit and an unknown and likely small amount use micro options, it's probably going to be slower to get around on a PEV versus a car. So in my tests, the scooter won, but in reality, the answer isn't one is going to be definitively faster than the other, but rather it depends. It depends on where you live, what direction you travel, what time of day, what time of year, among other factors. But at the end of the day, even if you can't save time, at least you can save some dough and some peace of mind by riding micro. So with that, my name is Nick. Thanks for watching.